questions. Let us continue with connective tissue. We started with dense connective tissue. You know, wherever connective tissue, we have three different types of connective tissue. That is loose connective tissue, fluid connective tissue, and dense connective tissue. We finished with loose connective tissue, and we started with dense connective tissue. Under dense connective tissue, we have bone and cartilage, and under that only we learned about tendons and ligaments. I hope there is no doubt with tendons and ligaments. So what is bone tissue? We know it is a dense connective tissue. The functions of bone are, it supports the body, like it forms our skeletal system, and it provides support to our body, and it gives place, it gives space for the attachment of muscles. So if ever you see, the muscles are attached to the bone, so it anchors muscle. And it supports the main organs. It supports the main organs means, right? If at all you're talking about skull and rib cage and the pelvic bone or the hip bone. Right? So when you just look at skull, the skull protects brain and rib cage protects our lungs and heart. And the pelvic bone and the hip bone, it supports the entire viscera, that is whatever the organs which are present in our abdominal cavity. So it supports that, it protects that, okay? So it supports main organs, and it is strong and non-flexible. So there is no doubt, bone, it is not flexible. Now let us move on to the next connective tissue, that is cartilage. Cartilage is widely spaced cell, right? When we talk about the bone tissue, the cells are compactly arranged. There is no space. That's why it makes it dense and hard. Whereas here, we find that it has matrix. In the matrix, their cells are arranged fast. So that means there is space is present. So widely spaced cells, right? And it has solid matrix, which is composed of proteins and sugar. Here the matrix is made up of calcium and phosphorus. Here we find it is made up of proteins and sugar. So where do you find cartilage? If you just touch your tip of your nose, when we touch the tip of our nose, it moves, right? It is flexible. What is this? This is actually cartilage. And when we the ear pinna of our ear, it is flexible. This is also made up of cartilage, right? So where you find, what are the functions? So here cartilage is flexible. Cartilage is flexible. It is strong, but it is flexible. It is elastic. You can move. We can move our ear lobes. That is, ear pinna, we can move, right? It bends, right? And it smoothens the surfaces at joint. That means, wherever joints are there. If there is a bone here and one more bone, in between the bone, we find the cartilage. In between the bones, we find the cartilage. The cartilage will act like a cushion. It gives support to the bone. Okay, so it acts as cushion. That's what it means. It smoothens the bone surfaces at joints. Wherever we find joints, we find the flexible. You find the cartilage. So whenever we talk about, say for example, vertebral column, you know our backbone. The backbone. So the backbone is not one continuous bone. It is made up of smaller bones, which we term it as vertebrae. So each is a smaller bones like this. Okay. In between these vertebrae, we find the cartilage. So it will act like a cushion. Okay, it gives a smooth finish at the places where the bones join. So the cartilage is flexible. Then, where else we find cartilage? So you have learned
trachea.
So what is trachea? Trachea is the windpipe. So where do you find this cartilage in trachea? You have learnt it in 8th standard. The cartilage is made, the trachea is made up of C-shaped cartilaginous rings. C-shaped cartilaginous rings. Yes. So you remember the structure of a respiratory system, right? So you know very well it is the windpipe is supported with the help of the cartilaginous ring, C-shaped cartilaginous ring, which we find throughout. That is, when the trachea breaks into bronchi and the bronchial, the bronchi will break into bronchioles, right? So everywhere we find this C-shaped ring. So what is the function of C-shaped ring? You know, it will provide support to the windpipe or the trachea. It prevents it from collapsing and it will keep the windpipe open. Thereby, it will facilitate the movement of air. So there we find the cartilage. And where else we find? You have heard about larynx. What is larynx? It is voice box. It is the voice box. So you know very well, we have a common passage. That is, we have a common passage for both food and air. The pharynx is the common passage for both food and air. So how the food will not enter into the windpipe? Any idea? We have learnt it in 8th standard, right? The food will not enter the windpipe because just above the larynx, there is a cartilaginous flap. There is a cartilaginous flap. We find a cartilaginous flap. What is it called? It is called epiglottis. Remember epiglottis? Epiglottis is the cartilaginous flap which will prevent the entry of the food particle into the windpipe. So that is also the cartilage. Okay, there also we find cartilage. Then where else we find cartilage? Okay, I already told you the nose tip. Till here we have the bone. If you just press it and touch, you can feel the bone. Then this part is stiff but it is flexible. So this is cartilage. Then where else we find? We find even in our ear. Okay, so we have certain places where it is, it should be tough, at the same time it should be flexible. We see the cartilage. Okay, I hope you understood what is cartilage and what, where it is present and what is it made up of. Okay, so with that we have come to the end of dense connective tissue. So we have learned what is dense connective tissue. Under dense connective tissue we have learned bone, cartilage, tendon and ligament. So we will go to the next tissue. Under connective tissue let us learn areolar tissue. So what is areolar tissue and what is its function? Let us learn.